Not too long ago, two brothers, they was jug fishing for some blue cats. They should have called it a day, but the moon was bright and the fish was biting.
What the hell was that?
They knew what they were doing. They've been fishing these waters all their life.
Jesse! 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 Where are you? Come on, man. Quit playing around.
The Rokin Phantom. That's what they've been calling it down here, as far back as I can remember. The Voodoo Shark.
Voodoo Shark.
The Mississippi River Delta is a beautiful but deadly place. There are dangers that everyone knows about. Massive alligators, quicksand, water moccasins, and other deadly monsters. But is there something more?
There's one shark out there that has never been caught. People around here call it the Rokin.
I've heard stories about this thing ever since I was a kid.
He gotta be over 100. He's ancient, almost like a dinosaur.
Oh, my grandpa used to tell me stories about it.
A lot of people believe it's a myth.
They say it's part fish, swamp monster.
Makes me even afraid to get in my bathtub.
Some people call it the voodoo shark.
Some people call him the ghost of the bayou.
And I call it just like it is. Straight up.
There have been rumors of a monster lurking in these waters for decades, terrorizing locals, attacking livestock, pets, even people. A voodoo shark. Few have seen it and lived to tell the tale. But evidence is mounting that it may be more than just a legend.
I thought I pulled a stump off the bottom. I didn't know what it was.
My boat is 18 foot long. His tail and his head was on both ends of my boat.
You know, Jaws is a story. This ain't no story. This is for real.
The other day when I was nutria hunting, I had a pretty good kill. I was, you know, starting to clean a few. And I threw a couple over. Blood go all in the water. Something hit the boat.
The hell was that?
I was scanning around looking, you know, around the other way, and every time it seems like when I look the other way, it came from the other way. Wow. I didn't see it, you know, I kept looking around.
Oh.
You know, at that point, when he hit my boat, I was just shaking up a little bit, like, whoa.
He actually hit your boat?
Yeah, ran into my boat, I saw his fin. Yeah, it scared me. I've never had that happen to me before. Yeah, if I was looking for him, I'd head over by the fort where I dump all my nutrias. I could sell you some of these hogs and nutrias, that way you could try baiting them up with that.
Great.
Back on the mighty Mississippi, the Cajun team camps out for the night.
Tell us a story, Uncle Blunt.
I'll tell you a true story, Nathan. Back a long time ago, John Lafitte, the pirate, used to hang out in these bayous. He couldn't bring his ship or his men to port, so he had to stay out here in the swamp. So one day, he sent out a party of hunters to gather meat. Well, 12 hours passed by, and 24 hours passed by, and no one returned. So he started getting a little worried. He sent out a search party to see if they could locate him. And when they returned, the fear in their eyes was bright. They told John Lafitte, all they found was the boat, and it had a massive bite out of it.
An alligator?
No, shark. And they say, still today, that the souls of the hunting party, their souls is still here. And they're tormented by the Rookin. I've been traveling these waters and these bayous since I was a little bitty kid with my grandfather. And you can mark these words, tomorrow, boys, we're gonna find it. We're finally gonna shed some light on what terrorizes these waters.
See, they got all of these stories about these sharks, 18 foot, 20 foot. We got sharks out here swallowed at.
I think it's a myth. I think the Rookin's a myth. Just like Bigfoot, they ain't found them either.
A lot of the fishermen around here like to stretch their little fish stories a little bit. I mean, they might catch a little fish this big, and it's gonna be this big. We're fishermen, you know how it is.